As FDA lead reviewer, some of the most common mistakes that I've seen when reviewing, submitting 510Ks, putting a focus on demonstrating substantial equivalence to your predicate. That's your aim. I actually think that's one of the more challenging things to do because here you are from a marketing perspective or even in your own eyes trying to innovate a new medical technology and trying to distinguish yourself from technology that currently exists. I mean, that's part of the drive of innovating new technology. And so in that vein, it's difficult to, with that mindset, it's difficult to put yourself into a mode to demonstrate that you're equivalent to something else. Another big pitfall that you see a lot with FDA submissions is not including enough narrative. And so we would get, for example, protocols, test protocols, or DV protocols, you know, validation, and things like that with, you know, a limited amount of text within the protocols that describe what the sponsor was doing. You need to put it in a little bit of a different context. You need to recognize that there's someone at the other side of the table reading this. And whereas your DV protocol might be there for the sake of doc control or something like that, making it a little more readable for an FDA lead reviewer is really important, and that's something I saw a lot of sponsors just not do very well. Another mistake that I often see in submissions is not the sponsor not understanding that there are certain lists out there that are actually publicly available that FDA provides on their website for different submissions for 510Ks, IDEs, et cetera, even pre-submission type meetings. It always seemed, not always, but it sometimes seemed like sponsors weren't doing their homework on what was required in the submission. So there's a refuse to accept checklist for different submissions now. And so you can go through this checklist and literally make your narrative with the headings of everything that's on that checklist. And it makes it that much easier for the lead reviewer to say, okay, they've done this, 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 and this. And when that's not there, it's just a lot harder to get things done. And so I think it's mutually beneficial because a reviewer can do things really quickly and you're going to get a response a lot quicker that way.